பிரியப்பட்ட கொச்சு கூட்டுக்காரே, சகோதரி சகோதரன்மாரே, எல்லாருக்கும் என்னுடைய நமஸ்காரம். ஐ எம் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு இனாகுரேட் தி 37th நேஷனல் லெவல் லேர்ன் டு லிவ் டுகெதர் கேம்ப் ஆர்கனைஸ்டு பை இந்தியன் கவுன்சில் ஃபார் சைல்டு வெல்ஃபேர் ICCW டு இன்கல்கேட் இன் அவர் சில்ட்ரன் a sense of solidarity, oneness and national unity. Stopping for a moment, I heard the speech of our honorable minister. She has rightly mentioned about the preamble of our constitution. This is what almost now I am at the end of my term. Whenever I visit school, college, in any function, I used to tell the preamble of the constitution, and the second is fundamental duties. If anyone aware or familiar with the preamble, nobody will claim that I am a Malayali or Tamilian or Kannadiga. We are all Indians. So when I was in Delhi for nearly 9 years, initially as a judge of the Supreme Court and finally Chief Justice of India, many persons from my home state, without getting a proper engagement, appointment, or knowing my position, they come and ask the security people at the gate to come and meet me. With reluctantly, I used to meet, but I advise them. See, you can't take advantage because I come from Tamil Nadu. You cannot, that is not a plus point for anyone. So we must clear that we are all Indians, that oneness must develop at the school level. Let me at the outset compliment in Kerala State Council for Child Welfare. The credit goes to our General Secretary, Mr. Deepak. Now, I participated several functions. Because of his interest only, this kind of program schemes, and last week also you might have seen, he arranged a continuous programs for the interest and welfare of the child. Let me at the outset compliment the State Kerala Council for Child Welfare for grabbing the opportunity to host this year's camp, which has the presence of over 200 children from almost all states, in particular 16, including our state Kerala, totally 17 states and union territories. Ever since its inception in 1959, the Kerala State Council for Child Welfare has been effectively formulating schemes and setting up institutions for the welfare of our children, implementing Charter of National Child Welfare Council, and encouraging meaningful legislation on child welfare. As a pattern of the council, I have been keenly observing the council's measures to improve the living conditions of our children and to accord educational opportunities to the children of the weaker sections of the society. Recently, I had the opportunity to attend the International Children's Film Festival organized by our state council. It was an impressive event attended by nearly 7,000 children. The council's projects like Amma Tottil, Sarana, Balayam, etc. have already won the appreciation of society. On the whole, the activities of the council have been with the noble aim of making Kerala a model in child-friendly measures. As we all know, children are the greatest assets of any nation, since today children are the citizens of tomorrow. Our first Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru had compared children to the buds in a garden and believed that they should be nurtured carefully and lovingly so that they blossom as well as groomed individuals who would lead our nation in the coming years. A great Lebanese poet advises us to give children our love but not our thoughts, because children have their own thoughts. As elders, we have a social obligation to provide our children opportunities and avenues to broaden their making and thinking and vision and ensure their overall development as future citizens. I am certain that this Learn to Live Together camp is one such opportunity for our children. I am informed that this camp has cross sections of the child population of India, since it has the participation of children from various backgrounds and physical conditions. I would request all the children participating in this camp to make this a true learning experience. This is an opportunity for our children to see the beauty of India's diversity and to understand its power to unite us as a nation. The interactions and cultural programs arranged in the camp should strengthen the friendship among the participants from different states and make them think about their common cultural heritage. In short, the insights which every child receives through such interactions would help him or her to develop a broader vision about India as a nation. It is on the strength of such vision that the children should grow as world citizens. As a person who served in the judiciary, I have always felt that such camps should also remind our children about their role as members of our society. Our children should know about the legal provisions which have established certain rights for children. Today, education is a fundamental right of every child. The Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act 2009 obligates the state to provide education to children in the age group of 6 to 14 years. In Kerala, we have strengthened the foundation of education by upgrading thousands of our classrooms as smart classrooms. We also have the Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006, which has set the age for marriage of boys at 21 years and that of girls at 18 years. In addition, we have laws against child labor and strict provisions to protect children from sexual assault and harassment. It is not enough that children are made aware of their rights. Society has the obligation to implement such laws properly. It is through the implementation of these rights that we help to reduce the inequalities among children and the disparities in their education, health and well-being. We also must encourage our education system to focus on enlightening children about their privileges in society so that they grow up being aware of society's duty towards them. A child thus empowered today is a promise of the prosperity of our future. I must specifically mention the need for knowledge about the rights of the differently abled children. Our children should grow up by knowing the importance of ensuring barrier-free facilities for differently abled. I am happy that this camp has endeavored to ensure their presence. Inclusion must be a way of life for every child. Along with the rights, children should also be aware of their duties as citizens. That is, fundamental right chapter mentions their duties. Such awareness can come only through meaningful social interactions which would give them a clear view of life around them. Unfortunately, we live in an age which is affected by two major issues. One is the unhealthy competition for scoring high marks, which makes children insensitive to the pulse of our society. And the second is the addiction to electronic device, which affect children in many ways. I have a feeling that these issues are hampering the process of social interactions among our children. Social gatherings like this camp are an answer to the rising levels of insensitivity among our children. It is such gatherings that they come face to face with the life of children in other parts of our country. These interactions also foster better understanding about the people of other regions among our children. I would suggest that we use the possibilities of these gadgets more to educate our children. We would even think of interactive mobile apps that would educate and sensitize children on issues like gender equality, fundamental rights and duties, and environmental protection. I hope that the Learn to Live Together camp would succeed in empowering our children with a broader view about the culture of our land, so that the destiny of India would be safe in their hands. I once again greet all the children taking part in this program and wish them all success in life and a very happy stay in Kerala. I also compliment the Indian Council for Child Welfare, New Delhi, for guiding and leading the activities related to child welfare in India. The Kerala State Council for Child Welfare also deserves praise for organizing this function and the camp in a befitting manner. Ellavarkum ende aashamsagal, nanni, jai hind.